Hello everyone, I am Deep Patel from the Department of Mechanical Engineering. Today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter number 11, that is coupling, clutch and brake. Okay, so first of all, before starting the chapter, you have to understand the meaning of coupling, clutches and brakes. Okay, we know that coupling is used to couple the two shafts. One is the driving shaft and second is the driven shaft. So we can transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft with the help of coupling. And there are various types of couplings are available: rigid coupling, flexible coupling. In the rigid coupling, there are muff coupling, flange coupling, etc. Now second one is the clutch. Clutch is also used to transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft whenever it is required. So if we fit one coupling between the two shaft, one is the driving and second is the driven, then what happens? That is the permanent connection is occurs between the driving shaft and the driven shaft. But when we are using the clutch to transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft, what the benefit we can get? If we do not require to transmit the power, then we can easily disengage the clutch, and whenever we require to transmit the power, we can easily engage the clutch. Okay, so according to our requirement, we can engage or disengage the clutch, and we can engage or disengage the driving and the driven shaft. Okay, so this is the basic difference between the coupling and the clutch. Now our third component is the brake. So we know the meaning of brake and what is the application of brake. Generally, brake is used to reduce the speed or to stop the vehicles. So in this chapter, we will discuss about the various types of the brakes, okay, like shoe brake, band brake or the disc brake. Okay, so in this lecture I am going to start first of all clutch, and today we will discuss about what is the clutch and which are the types of the clutches are available. Okay, so let us start with the clutch. So first of all, let us define the clutch. What is the meaning of clutch? Clutch is used to transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft machine. Okay, so we can say that it is used to engage and disengage the driving and the driven shaft whenever we require. It can be operated manually or it can be operated automatically. Okay, now there are various types of clutches are available in the market, and that are some example. First is the mechanical clutch, second is the pneumatic clutch, third is the hydraulic clutch, and fourth is the electromagnetic clutch. So according to our application, we are using different types of the clutch. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about three basic clutch. First is the disc clutch, second we will discuss about the cone clutch, and third we will discuss about the centrifugal clutch, and we will see its application. Okay, so let us start with our first type of the clutch, that is the disc clutch. Okay, so sometimes this disc clutch is also known as the plate clutch. Okay, and it can be single plate clutch or the multi-plate clutch. So generally in our two wheelers we are using this type of the clutch, that is the disc clutch or the plate clutch. Okay, so here you can see the figure. Here you can see in this diagram there are various types of the components are available. So first of all, we will discuss all the components one by one. Okay, here you can see driving shaft. So driving shaft is directly engaged with the engine, so it will rotate when the flywheel will rotate. Okay, so the engine will gives the power to the driving shaft. Okay, now second component is the driven shaft. Okay, so the driven shaft is directly engaged with the our wheel. Okay, so that is the driven shaft. So driven shaft is used to transmit the power to the vehicle. Okay, so driving shaft is transmit the power from the engine to the driven shaft, and driven shaft will transmit the power to the vehicle, so the vehicle will move ahead. Okay, now second is the spring. So here you can see what is the application of spring. Spring is used to create a force on the disc. Okay, whenever we want to engage or disengage, the spring force is used that will we will discuss later when we were discussing about the working of the disc clutch. Okay. Next is the operating lever. What is the application of operating lever? Operating lever is used to engage or disengage or to use to apply force on the plate or the disc. Okay. Next is the frictional disc. This is the most important component of the plate clutch. Okay. So, on the disc there are one liner is attached, that is the frictional liner, that can cause frictional force over the plate. Okay, and due to that frictional force, the power is transmitted from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, next there are two types of the flange. One is the driving flange and second is the driven flange. Okay, over which this plate is fitted. Okay, so this is what all about the components of the disc clutch. Now let us understand how this disc clutch is working. Okay, so first of all you have to understand that with the driving shaft one driving flange is fitted. Okay, and with the driven shaft the driven flange is fitted. Now when we want to shift the gear or we want to change the gear from one gear to second gear to third gear to fourth gear, we have to apply the clutch. Now when we press the pedal of the clutch, what happens? This disc will be disengaged from this driving flange. Okay, again I am repeating, whenever we want to shift the gear we apply the force on the lever or on the pedal. So what happens, whenever we apply the force on the pedal, the driven flange and the driving flange will be disengaged. Okay, so we can say that the plate clutch or the disc clutch will be disengaged from the driving shaft. Okay, so the whatever the power which was transmitted by the driving shaft to the driven shaft will be cut for some time. Okay, so when we operate the lever or when we press the lever, the power will not transmit from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, so the entire load on the vehicle will be reduced. Now we can easily shift the gear from first to second, for second to third, or third to fourth, we can easily shift the gear. After shifting the gear, what we are going to do, we are going to again remove the force from the pedal. So whenever we remove the force from the pedal, the spring will apply the force on the driven flange, so that the driven flange will be engaged with the driving flange and ultimately the plate will be engaged with the driving flange, so that the frictional force will be applied between the driven flange and the driving flange. So ultimately after the removal of the load from the pedal, the driving shaft will transmit the power to the driven shaft. Then we can easily transmit the power with the help of the disc clutch. Okay, so simply we can understand that when we are going to apply force on the pedal, the driving flange and the driven flange are disengaged, so the power transmission can be cut for some time. Okay, and during this time we can shift the gear from first to second or second to third. Okay, after that we are going to remove the load from the pedal, then the clutch will be engaged, so the driving shaft can transmit the power to the driven shaft. This is how with the help of clutch we can engage or disengage the driving shaft and the driven shaft. We can transmit the power or we can cut the power for the sometimes. Okay, so this is the simple application of the disc clutch. Generally this type of the disc clutch are used in the automobile vehicle, two wheeler or the four wheeler. Generally single plate clutch is used in the four wheelers and the multi plate clutch is used in the two wheeler. Why we are using the multi plate clutch? Because to increase the frictional force. Okay, whenever we increase the number of plates, then we are going to increase the frictional force. So if the frictional force is high, then we can easily transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, so this is the application of the disc clutch. Okay, so here all the description is given. Okay, in this type of the clutch consists of the two flange. One is the driving flange and second is the driven flange. Driving flange is directly attached with the driving shaft and the driven flange is attached with the driven shaft. Okay, in the normal working condition both the shafts are engaged by the clutch due to spring force. Okay, so the spring will apply the force over the disc so that they will make engagement. Okay, now when the power is not required at the driven shaft, the driven flange is disengaged from the driving flange by the operating lever. Okay, so whenever we apply the force on the lever, it will disengage. Okay, so we can say that the single disc clutches are used in the automobile when the large torque transmission is required, the multi plate clutch are used. Okay, so we can use single plate clutch or the multi plate clutch according to our applications. Okay, now our next type of the clutch is the cone clutch. So this is the simple diagram of the cone clutch. Okay, here you can see there is one difference between the disc clutch and the cone clutch. The remaining components are same, that is the driving shaft which is used to transmit the power from the engine, that is one driven shaft which is used to transfer the power to the our vehicle, and operating lever, that all are same. Okay, and the spring force is also applied. Now here instead of disc we are using the cone. Okay, one is the outer core and one is the inner cone. So what is the application or why we are using this cone? So in the disc clutch we have to provide more axial force to engage and disengage. Okay, we have to provide more force on the pedal to engage and disengage the driving shaft and the driven shaft. Now we want to reduce this axial pressure or axial force on the clutch, then we can use this type of the cone clutch. Okay, so with the less amount of the force we can easily engage or disengage the driving shaft and the driven shaft if we are using the cone clutch. Okay, so here there are two types of the cone, one is the outer cone and one is the inner cone, and this outer core and the inner cone can be engaged and disengaged easily with the small axial force. Okay, so we can reduce the axial pressure or axial force with the help of this cone clutch. Okay, so this is the driving cone and second is the driven cone. Driven cone is the inner cone and the driving cone is the outer cone. Okay, the working is same. Whenever we want to shift the gear from first to second or from second to third, then we have to operate the lever. So we are going to provide force on the operating lever. So what happens? The inner cone and outer cone will be disengaged for some time. So the power will not be transmitted from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, now we are going to shift the gear. Then what happens? We are going to reduce the force or we are going to remove the force from the operating lever so that the inner cone will be directly engaged with the outer cone, and there in between the surface of the driving cone and the driven cone there is a frictional material is provided. So due to the frictional force it will transmit the power from the outer cone to the inner cone, and the inner cone is directly attached to the driven shaft so that it can easily transmit the power to the vehicle. Okay, so in between the frictional liner is provided. Okay, so in the inside surface of the outer cone and on the above surface of the inner cone the frictional liner is provided, so we can easily transmit the power from the outer cone to the inner cone. Okay, so this is simply how this cone clutch is work. Generally this type of the cone clutch is used in the off-road vehicle whenever we want to easily transmit the gear. Okay, so this is what all about the working of the cone clutch. Okay, so that all I have described here, that this type of the clutch is consist of the two cone. One cone is key to the driving shaft and second cone is key to the driven shaft. Driving shaft cone is known as the driving cone or the outer cone, and the cone which is engaged with the driven shaft is known as the driven cone, or simply it is called the inner cone. Generally in the normal working condition both the shafts are remain engaged with the clutch due to the spring force. Here the spring force will be applied, so the inner cone and the outer cone can make the engagement. Okay, now whenever we want to shift the gear or when the power is not required at the driven shaft, then we are going to press the lever so that the driving cone and the driven cone will be disengaged. Okay, so we can say that the main advantage of this type of the cone clutch is that the axial pressure which is applied is reduced. So this is the difference between the disc clutch and the cone clutch. In the cone clutch, we have to provide less axial pressure compared to the disc clutch, so we can easily shift the gears in the cone clutch. Okay, also we can make more frictional resistance in the cone clutch, so we can easily transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, so this is what all about the cone clutch. Okay, now our third type of the clutch is the centrifugal clutch. Okay, so generally in the automatic vehicles we are going to use the centrifugal clutch. Okay, whenever we do not want to shift the gear, okay, like in the Activas or in the Jupiter, we do not require to shift the gear, there we are going to use this type of the clutch, that is the centrifugal clutch. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the components of the centrifugal clutch. So you can see in the figure that the one is the driving shaft, second is the driven shaft, both are as it is. Okay, now whenever we want to transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft, we are going to use the centrifugal clutch. Okay, so here in the centrifugal clutch you can see there is one spider. Okay, and above the spider there are frictional liner is provided, and the frictional liner are attached with the spring. Okay, you can see in the figure that the frictional liner or the shoe element which are attached with the spring, and spring is directly attached with the spider, you can see. Okay, now there are one ream, so we are calling it as a ream of the pulley. Okay, now what happens here, whenever we want to transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft, in the automatic vehicles we can use this type of the clutch. So what happens here, we know the driving shaft is directly attached with the engine, so whenever we are going to start the engine, this driving shaft will be rotated. Now when the driving shaft will be rotated, the spider will be rotated with the driving shaft. Okay, and if the spider will be rotated, then the shoe which are engaged with the spider will also be rotated. Okay, so here you have to understand there are two types of the forces are involved in this. One is the spring force and second is the centrifugal force. The spring force which is applied by the spring and second is the centrifugal force. Now whenever we are going to rotate the driving shaft and the spider will be rotated, there will be a centrifugal force will be acting on the shoe. So the frictional shoe will tries to move away from the spider. Okay, so the centrifugal force is apply on the frictional shoe, and second the spring force is apply on the frictional shoe. Okay, now this both the force are in the opposite direction. Centrifugal force are going to act on the shoe in the away to the spider, and the spring force will tries to force the frictional shoe near to the spider. Okay, so there are two type of the opposite force. The centrifugal force is away from the center and the spring force is tries to move the shoe towards the center. Okay, so these are the two different forces are available in the centrifugal clutch. Now whenever we start the engine, so the spider will be rotated and the centrifugal force will be applied. Now if the rotating speed is very high, then according to the formula of the centrifugal force, we can say that centrifugal force is equals to mr omega square. So when we are going to increase the speed, the amount of centrifugal force which is acting is rise. Okay, so if the centrifugal force is higher than the spring force, then what happens, the shoe will be directly engaged with the ring of the pulley, and the above the shoe there are the frictional liner is attached. Okay, so due to the frictional force it will rotate the ring. Now here ream of the pulley is directly attached with the driven shaft. Okay, so it will rotate the driven shaft. So ultimately here what happens, due to the centrifugal force the shoes are moving outward from the center, then the frictional liner is attached with the shoe, so that due to that frictional the ream of the pulley will be rotated, and the ream of the pulley is directly attached with the driven shaft, so the driven shaft will be rotated, and ultimately we are going to transmit the power to the vehicle. Okay, so this is how due to the centrifugal force we can transmit the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, so we call this type of the clutch as the centrifugal clutch. Okay, so this is what all about the working of centrifugal clutch. Okay, so all the description is given here, that in the centrifugal clutch is consist of the number of shoes. There are four shoes or the six shoes inside the drum or the rim of the pulley. Now upper side surface of the shoe is attached with the frictional liner. Okay, now the spider is fitted on the driving shaft. So whenever we are going to rotate the driving shaft, the spider will be rotated, and due to the mass of the shoe, whenever the spider and the shoe will be rotated, the centrifugal force is acting on the shoe. So the shoe will tries to moving outward. Okay, now when the centrifugal force is equal to the spring force, the shoe is just floating. And if the centrifugal force is greater than the spring force, then the shoe will be attached with the rim of the pulley and ultimately it will transfer the power to the driven shaft. Okay, so this is what all about the working of the centrifugal clutch. Now what is the application? The application of centrifugal clutch is in the automatic vehicle where we do not want to shift the gear. Okay, so we can say that the centrifugal clutch is ultimately working on the speed. Okay, whenever we are going to provide more speed, there will be a tight engagement between the shoe and the rim of the pulley, so we can easily transmit the power. Okay, so this is what all about the three clutches. First, we have understood about the disc clutch. Second, we have understood about the cone clutch. And third, we have understood about the centrifugal clutch. Okay, so this is what all about today's lecture. Thank you for today.